Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So we meet again for PSC 104, the basic natural rubber processing. Today we continue with chapter 7, which is the free grades materials. So here is the course outline for chapter 7. Firstly, we will cover on the free grades rubber, which is the autocoagulated rubber itself, and then free grade collection and reception process, and finally the method of storage. So basically there is only 3 subchapter in chapter 7. The course learning outcome, okay, the first one at the end of this chapter, students should be able to define and differentiate types of free grade rubber. I think there is 4 types of free grade rubber. To describe the concerns during free grade collection and reception, to explain the storage method of free grade rubbers, and finally to describe the importance of DRC determinations. Okay. We start with the chapter 7.1, the free grade rubber. Okay, what is free grade rubber? Free grade rubber is autocoagulated rubber. That rubber tap, the rubber from a tap tree is collected in a tree form, either latex, scapulum, and trellis. Okay, so free grade rubber are those that have autocoagulated in a field. Free grade rubber may be divided into 4 groups. First one is scapulums, then we have trellis, bark scraps, and the ground scraps. So later on I will explain further on this type of free grade rubber. So basically here the free grade rubber is latex that flow from the tapered tree and it left maybe at least overnight or a day before it can be collected as a autocoagulated rubber. So here we start with the scapulum. What is scapulum? Scapulum is produced when the latex is left uncollected and allowed to coagulate due to the bacterial actions on the sides of the collecting cups. Okay. Filled coagulum or scapulum is eventually collected, cut, clean, crimp, and crumbs. In other words, scapulum is the rubber derived from the after dripping of latex left in the cups following latex collection. So basically what happened here, during the tapping process, early in the morning you collect the latex itself, and then you allow the excessive latex that drips into a cups overnight and allow it to autocoagulate, and you collect that scapulums the following morning. Okay, so here you are promoting the autocoagulation process for the field grade processing. Okay, next is a trellis. Trellis is a coagulated residue left around the barks of the tree where the cut has been made for tapping. Okay, the formation of trellis reseal the latex vessel and stop the flow of rubber latex. It's normally processed with the cup lumps. Trellis is the thin strip of rubber derived from the last drop of latex flowing from the tapping cuts and down groove and spouts. It is contaminated with iron, manganese iron, absorbed from the barks of the tree and often contain bark chipping. So here also the residue of the latex dripping from yesterday tapping process, and then you collect the three laces from the groove that you already made during the tapping process itself. Okay. Next is the bark scrap and the ground scrap. Okay, bark scrap is a thin film of rubber derived from the latex that has overflown the cut due to the poor tapping practice or rain interference. The former includes too large or too small tapping cut angle, insufficient depth of cut, and blunt knife. Okay, usually bark scrap is overflown of your latex from the groove that you tap process. Okay, because of insufficient depth of the cut and blunt knife, it causes the latex to overflow from the groove itself. So bark scrap is nearby the trellis itself. And then we have the ground scrap or we call the Earth's Crab, is a rubber derived from the latex that has overflown the cup due to the bad tapping process, inefficient field management and rain interference. Ground scrap is contaminated with leaf, earth, twigs, and it's rarely encountered. Okay, this ground scrap is a overflown of latex from the cup itself. So it will drip on a ground and you need to collect it because you don't want to promote any microbial growth in a field. Next, we have our rain guards. Okay, this is the common rain guard technique that been used in Asian country. Rain can get into a collection directly or by drainage down trunks when either its excessive rubber be lost into bark or ground scrap due to overflow and will affect the properties of the rubber from the latex collection. This major problem is effectively eliminated, but heavy shower and draining rain cannot be guarded against with this method. 3/8 inch thick polystyrene sheet with 2x4 is cut using a hot wire cutter into strips. One larger face is painted with fill or concentrated latex containing a marking color for easy identification and allowed to dry. Okay, the length of strip is around 6-8 inch longer than the tapping card. So actually the function of the rain guards to protect your tree from capture any rain interference during the rainy seasons. But of course the heavy shower cannot be guarded using a rain guard. And then we have a polybag rubber. What is polybag rubber? This is a novel technique where the whole crop is collected in polyethylene PE bag instead of cups, and it's only collected after several tapping when the bag is full of completely autocoagulated latex. PE sheet is manufactured into bags and hung in stirrups supported by three. The spout enters the bag through a small hole and the latex run in a normal way. The PE is stripped at the reception and disposed of, leaving the coagulant ready for further processing. So here, actually the practice is similar with the cups itself, but the poly bag have a narrow or very what we call a small area of latex to drip into a poly bag itself, and it has a bigger space and volumes areas so that you can collect more autocoagulated rubber. And it is specifically used for manufacturing of field grade material. So in other words, you only collect your field grade rubber, okay, after a several tapping. So maybe after 4 to 5 days until the poly bags are nearly full or already full, you will collect the whole autocoagulated rubber. The advantage of poly bag, the tapper taps the tree and collect the three lays only. The bulk of collection is brought by unskilled labor. The whole crop except the three lays is received clean. Coagulation in the factory is eliminated. Collection lorry capacity can be fully utilized and collection station disappear. Individual tree performance can be visually and semi-quantitatively recorded. Okay, here, what you need to do is the tappers only tap the tree every day and did not collect the autocoagulated rubber. Okay, the bulk collection will be collected by the unskilled labor. Only skilled labor used to be a tapper to tap the tree. Okay, and then the whole crop except the tree lays is received clean. Why? Because it is not open environment as what we call, you use a cups for your collecting your autocoagulated rubber as compared to this polybag. And the coagulation in the factory is eliminated because you allow this latex to autocoagulate in a field itself. And then collection lorry capacity can be fully utilized and collection station disappear. Okay, because of you only timely collect your autocoagulated rubber or the polybag rubber, so you did not collect every day. by doing this, you can fully utilize the capacity of the lorry to collect your polybag rubber. And at the same time, the collection station disappear. So you don't need to collect all your cup lump and put it in a collection station, wait until it full enough for a lorry to collect. Okay. And then the most interesting part in research is individual trip performance can be visually and semi-quantitatively recorded, because you know each of the individual tree produce a different amounts of latex. So if you're having different clones of a rubber tree, you can quantitatively measure the performance or the yield of the individual tree itself. But it also have a disadvantage. The cost of PA bags over a period exceeds that of cup. So eventually, if you use for a long term for polyethylene polybag rubber, the cost of PE bag itself will exceed the usage of the cup, because cups you can use quite what we call that for until it's broken. Only then you will replace a new cups. Okay. There is an additional cost for labor fixing new bag. So there is previously what you do with the conventional way of collecting rubber scraps or the cup lump itself is by having one labor which is tap the tree, collects the and collects the cup lump itself. But nowadays, using a polybag rubber, you need another labor to fix your PE bags onto a rubber tree. Stripping PE and additional cost itself. There may be some oxidation over a long period. Okay, because of the collections is on not daily collections, you may collect after a few days, maybe until it the PE bag full or semi-full, which is might require 4 to 5 days before it can be collected. The first yield of the latex, the autocoagulated, may be oxidized and impart in dark in color. Okay. Next disadvantage is the risk of the theft, because the tendencies of you left your rubber on a tree for a few days, and there is a tendency that theft will collect your rubber before you can collect your rubber itself. The product is darker than traditional latex grade, of course, the oxidation process. And then premium grades such as SMR 5L, CV and concentrate cannot be manufactured because the oxidation and dark in color. Okay. And then we go to the field grade collection and reception. Okay. The field grade collection, the collection center upon field grade rubber and the quality is largely dependent upon the hygiene since coagulation is uncontrolled. All tapping utensils must be cleaned to prevent dirt contamination. Collection and reception are carried out as soon as possible to reduce the incidence of oxidation by sunlight and excessive drying out. As surface is drying out, the rubber harden, making dirt removal is difficult in a factory. And then field grade rubber producer receive field grade from many sources. The cup lump and tree lace collection will be about the same quality from day to day, but usually there is only sufficient to process after accumulation for a week. So, and this in turn involves storage. There are four methods of storage, namely sunlight storage, smoking, wetting, and total immersion. And then method of storage, okay, we cover three types of storage. The first one is sunlight storage. The process is to expose to sunlight with deteriorate tree lace rapidly, and even after 1 week storage, the rubber become hard to process and will impair most of the physical properties such as viscosity and hardness. Second one is the weight storage. A light water spray prevent fecalgium from become hard, hence facilitate cleaning and blending later. So it's almost similar to the sunlight storage, but you sprinkle water to prevent it from harden. However, continual washing action result in removal of natural occurring antioxidant and serrated with consequence reduction in quality. So prolonged wet storage is not recommended. Then the third one is smokehouse or dry storage. This method is employing by smallholders who have neither large tank nor adequate water supplies. The field grate is normally left on the floor of the smokehouse where the RSS or the rib smoke sheet is being produced to prevent the bad smelling because of the process of microbial activity. This technique makes subsequent dirt removal is difficult, although physical properties are unaffected. Okay. The fourth one and the last one of the storage is a total immersion. Require a big tank to soak the field coagulant. Will also encourage leaching of naturally occurring antioxidant and serrator. The advantage are the initial blending is simple. Mineral and organic contaminant have time to settle out or separate to the surface, and chemical treatment may meet it desired. Total immersion period is of about 2 weeks is a maximum tolerable if standard quality product is demanded. So prolonged storage more than 2 weeks is not recommended. And then the DRC. What is DRC? It's dry rubber content determination. Why it is important? Okay. Okay, the DRC of latex is a percentage of weight of dry sheet over weight of latex tested. Okay, individual taper collections are normally weighed at reception and by experience and estimate DRC is recorded for payment purposes. A similar estimation is made by experienced personnel for lorry loads and field grade rubber in remailers or estate factory. It is necessary to determine DRC on the field latex in an estate as well as the factory because of the following reason. Okay, what do we take a look what the reason are. The first one is for trading purpose. When trading is involved, payment is made based on the DRC of field latex. Therefore, deceitful by adding water into fresh latex can be avoided. So you only pay depending on the DRC value. Although the tappers or what we call the tappers try to deceive you by adding water to increase the volume and the weight of your latex. But then you only pay depending on the DRC. Okay. The second one for chemical addition. Okay. The amounts of chemical, example, antioxidants, sodium, metabisulfate to be added in the free latex is based on DRC. Yes. Chemical addition is strongly dependent on the DRC value. You need to know before you can add your chemical. So the amount, the higher the amount of DRC, the more chemical might be required. And then for coagulation process, the molasses is added based on DRC is in assisted biological coagulation. Previously on chapter 3, I think, we did cover on the ABC process. Okay, the mixture of diethyl sulfocyanates and calcium chloride are added based on the DRC in continuous coagulation process. The other purposes is for preservative addition in preservative system. The level of hydroxylamine in latex is based on the RC for hydroxylamine ammonia preserve system, HNS preservative system. And then the qualitative and quantitative analysis of the estate production to evaluate or for recording purposes of estate production. Okay, I think that's all from me for chapter 7. I hope to see you. If you have any question, feel free to ask me. And I hope to see you for the next chapter. By then, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.